Hello everyone. Today we are going to start a series of lectures on WBC neoplasms or white blood cells neoplasms. So the first of all, the first thing that we need to study is leukemias and lymphomas. So what basically is leukemia and what is lymphoma? We should have a clear understanding in our mind that what is leukemia. So leukemia is defined basically as a neoplastic proliferation. It is a neoplastic proliferation of precursor white blood cells in the marrow. So leukemia is nothing but it is the neoplastic proliferation of precursor white blood cells in the marrow. These precursor white blood cells are basically the precursor white blood cells in the marrow. Now and after, there is neoplastic proliferation of white blood cells in the marrow, these neoplastic cells also spills into circulation. Hence we'll have a hypercellular marrow, with leukemia in the blood. That is also known as excessive leukocytosis. Now what is lymphoma? Lymphoma is also a lymphoid neoplasm. Lymphoma is also a lymphoid neoplasm, but this lymphoid neoplasm is restricted to the lymph nodes, and other lymphoid organs in the form of cohesive masses. So what is leukemia? Leukemia is a neoplastic proliferation of precursor white blood cells, and these white blood cells, they spill into the blood circulation, whereas lymphoma is a lymphoid neoplasm of lymph nodes and other lymphoid tissue, and they form cohesive masses in the lymph nodes. But these definitions are not very specific. Like leukemias, we are having leukemias that can transform into lymphomatous phase, whereas we have lymphomas that can transform into leukemic phase. So let's say this is our bone marrow house. And this is our systemic circulation. Okay, so in the bone marrow house, there is excessive proliferation of white blood cells. In leukemia, in the bone marrow house, there is excessive proliferation of white blood cells, such that the whole bone marrow is compromised. So along with this situation in the bone marrow, these white blood cells, they also spills into the circulations in the blood. So these white blood cells are also present in the circulation. So this condition is known as a leukemia. Okay. Now, when these leukemic cells, they are spreading into the circulation, they can also spill into lymph nodes. They can also go towards liver, and they can also go toward spleen. And why is this so? This is because these leukemic cells, these white blood cells, were initially in the fetal life, they were synthesized in the lymph nodes, liver and spleen. spleen. So these precursor white blood cells, as they are in excess number in the marrow, they have greater propensity to go towards the places where they used to be synthesized or they used to reside in the fetal life. So these precursor white blood cells, as they are in excess amount in the blood circulation, they can also go and reach to these places. So with leukemia, we often see hepatosplenomegaly and lymph nodes involvements. And when the lymph nodes are involved in the leukemia and they form cohesive masses, we can say that leukemia is transformed. That this leukemia is transformed into lymphoma. Whereas, what is lymphoma? Lymphoma is basically a lymphoid tumor that arises from the lymph nodes and is forming a cohesive masses. Now, in this lymph node, a lymphoid tumor is forming a cohesive mass, but this tumor can also spill into circulation sometimes. Means that this tumor undergoes some mutation, that this tumor also spills into circulation, and we can say that this lymphoma has now transformed into a leukemia. So we can say that leukemia can be transformed into a lymphoma, whereas a lymphoma can be transformed into a leukemia. WHO classifies lymphoid neoplasms based upon certain genetic features, morphology, and immunohistochemistry, and clinical features. So keeping in mind the genetic behavior, the morphology, the immunohistochemistry, and the clinical features of these lymphoid tumors or lymphoid neoplasms, WHO has classified leukemias and lymphomas into five major categories. So before going into these categories, let's make the concept of leukemia and lymphoma more clear to understand this classification. So let's say we are having a cell, and this cell is a pluripotential hematopoietic stem cell. This pluripotential hematopoietic stem cell, it divides into a cell known as lymphoid progenitor cell and a cell known as myeloid progenitor cell. So now consider this lymphoid progenitor cell, and this lymphoid progenitor cell is also known as a lymphoblast. This lymphoblast, this undergoes a series of transformation, and finally this lymphoblast is converted into mature cells that are either B cells, T cells, or natural killer cells. So the cell which is present here, the lymphoblast, it is an immature cell. Whereas these cells are mature cells. This lymphoblast is undifferentiated cell. Whereas these lymphocytes are more differentiated. So, along with being undifferentiated, these lymphoblasts are functionless, whereas lymphocytes are functional. Also, the lymphoblasts are large cells and the lymphocytes are small cells. Lymphoblasts are large, they are immature, they are undifferentiated, and they are functionless. Whereas the lymphocytes are small cells and they are differentiated cells. They are functional cells and they are mature cells. So if a tumor or a neoplasm arises from a lymphoblast, or it arises from a cell which is present near to this lymphoblast. So this tumor will have features which are similar to this lymphoblast. So this tumor cells will be large, they will be immature, they will be undifferentiated, and they will be functionless. Whereas if a tumor arises somewhere from here, that is along the lineage, it is near to the lymphocyte stage. So this tumor will have features of which are similar to lymphocytes, or features which are similar to mature cells. So the tumor which will arise from this stage, from this right side of the lineage, this tumor will be have small cell, and these cells will be mature, these cells will be differentiated, and these cells will be more functional. So keeping in mind these properties, we can say that a tumor which is arising from this stage, or a tumor which is arises from immature precursor cell, this tumor will have an acute or stormy onset. Whereas a tumor which is arising from progenitors which are near to the lymphocyte stage, so this will have chronic or slow onset. Okay. Another thing, that this stage is known as precursor stage. This stage is known as precursor stage. That is, these cells are the precursor cells of lymphocytes. Whereas lymphocytes, this B cells, T cells, and NK cells, they are peripheral cells. They are present in the peripheral circulation. So these cells are peripheral cells. So now let's understand that if a tumor which is arising from this initial stage, from this precursor stage, this tumor will be called a precursor tumor. Whereas if a tumor is arising from the cells or from the progenitors which are near to the lymphocyte stage, so this tumor will be known as a peripheral tumor. So there were two things. One thing was that either a tumor will be acute or chronic, or either it will be precursor or peripheral. So as this thing is clear in our minds, so now what is the WHO classification? So if a tumor is arising from this stage, from this initial stage, this tumor will be known as acute, precursor. If this cell was a precursor B cell, so this tumor will be known as acute, precursor B cell lymphoma or leukemia. But if this precursor cell is a T cell, precursor T cell, the tumor will be known as acute precursor T cell leukemia or lymphoma. Okay, but if the tumor is arising from these peripheral stages or from these mature stages, and the cell is a precursor B, is a peripheral B cell, so this will be known as chronic peripheral B cell lymphoma or a leukemia. And if it's arising from precursor peripheral T cells, so this will be known as peripheral T cell lymphoma or a leukemia. So this was easy. Just add natural killer cell and natural killer cell with this T cell. That is, the tumor can be acute precursor T cell or natural killer cell leukemia or lymphoma, or peripheral T cell or natural killer cell leukemia or lymphoma. And the final thing is Hodgkin's lymphoma. Hodgkin's lymphoma. So WBC has classified the lymphoid neoplasms into 5 categories. Number 1 is acute precursor or a precursor B cell leukemia and lymphoma. Precursor B cell leukemia and lymphoma. So in this category comes ALL. And this ALL is known as pre-B-ALL. Precursor B cell ALL is an example of precursor B cell leukemia and lymphoma. Precursor B cell ALL is an example of precursor B cell leukemia and lymphoma. Now, what comes in the category of this peripheral B cell lymphoma and leukemia? So, peripheral B cell lymphomas are certain non-Hodgkin's lymphomas. And these non-Hodgkin's lymphomas can be either mantle zone lymphoma, or it can be follicular lymphoma, or it can be marginal zone lymphoma, or it can be hairy cell leukemia, etc. And I will explain all of these lymphomas in a while. Okay, this precursor T cell leukemia and lymphoma, so it comprises of a tumor which is known as in this precursor T cell leukemia and lymphoma, it comprises of tumor which is known as pre-TALL, which means that precursor T cell acute lymphocytic lymphoma. So precursor T cell acute lymphocytic lymphoma is a category or is an example of acute precursor T cell leukemia and lymphoma. So our final thing is that Hodgkin's lymphoma. Hodgkin lymphoma is a special group of lymphomas which are having characterized Reed-Sternberg cells. Hodgkin lymphomas are those set of lymphomas which are having characteristic Reed-Sternberg cells, whereas non-Hodgkin lymphomas are those lymphoma which lacks these characteristics Reed-Sternberg cells. So till now we have discussed that WHO has classified the leukemias and lymphomas into 5 categories. The first category was precursor B cell leukemia and lymphoma. For example, precursor B cell acute lymphoblastic leukemia or lymphoma. The second category was precursor T cell leukemia or lymphoma. So precursor T cell leukemia and lymphomas is comprised of precursor T cell acute lymphoblastic leukemia. Okay. The third category is peripheral B cell lymphoma and leukemia. And this peripheral B cell lymphoma or leukemias consist of certain non-Hodgkin's lymphomas that are mantle zone lymphomas, follicular lymphomas, marginal zone lymphomas, there are hairy cell leukemias, and CLL, chronic lymphocytic leukemia. Chronic lymphocytic leukemia or small lymphocytic lymphoma. This is also an example of peripheral B cell lymphoma or leukemia. And Hodgkin lymphomas, as I told you, Hodgkin lymphomas is a specialized group of lymphomas which are having characteristic Reed-Sternberg cells, whereas non-Hodgkin lymphomas are lacking these Reed-Sternberg cells. And peripheral T cell lymphomas and leukemias also consist of various other types of peripheral T cells, lymphomas and leukemias. So in this diagram I have shown you a section of a bone marrow, thymus and lymph nodes. As we know that are B cells develop in the bone marrow, whereas the T cell develops in the thymus. So let's first imagine the development of B cells. So B cell is the initial cell which forms. B cell is known as common lymphoid progenitor cell. This common lymphoid progenitor cell divides and it gives rise to 3B lymphoblast. 3B lymphoblast or precursor B cell lymphoblast. This precursor B cell lymphoblast then divides and it gives rise to another cell which is known as a naive B cell. Why is this cell called naive B cell? Because this cell is not yet antigenically stimulated, hence it is known as a naive B cell. This naive B cell then gains entry into the mental zone, into the mental zone of a lymph node, and this naive B cell then enters the mental zone of the lymph nodes. After having gaining entry into the mental zone of the lymph node, the naive B cell enters to the follicular zone of the lymph node, into the follicle of the lymph node. And here in the follicles of the lymph node, it undergoes a process which is known as somatic hypermutation. Somatic hypermutation. What is somatic hypermutation? So here we are having a naive B cell, and this naive B cell was not yet antigenically stimulated. Hence, we call it a naive B cell. This naive B cell enters the lymph node into the mental zone, and after the entry into the mental zone, it enters the follicular zone. And here in the follicular zone, it is exposed to antigens. And when it is exposed to antigens, it makes antigen receptor that are specific for the specific antigen. And this process is known as somatic hypermutation. So after undergoing somatic hypermutation, this cell then gains entry into another region, and this zone is known as marginal zone. This zone is known as extranodal marginal zone here. So what was the scheme? The scheme was that you are having a common lymphoid progenitor cell, which then undergoes division and forms the pre-B lymphoblast. Then it forms naive B cell. Then it forms then it enters into the mental zone of the lymph node. Then it gains entry into the follicular zone of the lymph node, and then it undergoes somatic hypermutation, and then it gains entry to the extranodal marginal zone of the lymph nodes. Okay. What happens in the thymus here? So in the thymus, we are having a different type of story. And this story is that we are having a double negative T cell. And this double negative T cell first forms double positive T cell. That is, it will possess both CD4 and CD8. This double positive T cell is then converted into either CD4 positive T cell or a CD8 positive T cell. And these CD4 and CD8 positive T cells, they gain entry into the blood. Hence, they are present in the peripheral circulation. Here we will have both CD4 positive and CD8 positive T cell. So now, if this scheme is clear into your mind, we will revise our tumors in a second. That if a tumor is arising from here, from this precursor B cell lymphoblast, this tumor will be known as pre-B. So the tumor which will develop from this pre-B lymphocyte, this tumor will be known as pre-B acute lymphoblastic leukemia. And this precursor B cell acute lymphoblastic leukemia, as it is developing from the precursor cell, as it is developing from an immature cell, precursor B cell acute lymphoblastic leukemia will have acute onset, and it falls in the category of B cell acute lymphoblastic leukemia, pre-B acute lymphoblastic leukemia. Then this naive B cell, if a tumor develops from this naive B cell, this tumor will be known as C ALL. Chronic lymphocytic leukemia or small lymphocytic lymphoma, SLL. So, if a tumor develops from a naive B cell, this tumor will be known as CLL or SLL. CLL, chronic lymphocytic leukemia, and small lymphocytic lymphoma. So, as it is near to the mature cell, as the naive B cell, it is near to mature cells and it's a bit more mature than the BB lymphoblast. Hence, the tumor will be tumor will have chronic onset and it will not be acute. Hence, the tumor will have chronic onset. Hence, it's given the name chronic lymphocytic leukemia or small lymphocytic lymphoma. And this CLL and SLL falls in the category of peripheral B cell leukemia and lymphoma. Whereas this precursor B cell acute lymphoblastic leukemia falls in the category of precursor B cell leukemia and lymphoma. Okay, now if a tumor develops from this cell, and as I told you that this cell is known as, this cell is present in the margin, in the mental zone, as this cell is present in the mental zone, so if a tumor develops from this cell, this tumor will be known as, and it is present in the lymph nodes, and it will form cohesive mass. This tumor will form cohesive mass in the lymph nodes, so this will not be a leukemia, but this tumor will be a lymphoma, and as it's developing from mental zone, so it will be known as mental zone lymphoma. This tumor is known as mental zone lymphoma. And as it's also developing from a mature cell, from a more mature cell, and it's present in the periphery, so this also falls in the category of peripheral B cell neoplasms. Okay, now if a tumor develops from this region, from cells of this follicular region, so this tumor will be known as follicular lymphoma. Why is it called follicular? It is called follicular because it develops from this follicular region and it forms follicles. And why it is a lymphoma? It is a lymphoma because it forms cohesive masses, and it is also a category of peripheral B cell leukemias and lymphomas. Okay, now this cell, if a tumor develops from this cell here, and this cell is present in the extranodal marginal region, so this tumor will be known as extranodal marginal zone lymphoma. So all these lymphomas and the CLL, they are peripheral B cell lymphomas and leukemias. And these lymphomas, this mental zone lymphoma, this follicular lymphoma, and this extranodal marginal zone lymphomas, all of them are non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. And I told you earlier that non-Hodgkin lymphomas are those lymphomas which do not possess characteristic Reed-Sternberg cells. Okay. So now, if a tumor develops from this double negative T cell in the thymus, this tumor will be known as pre-TALL or precursor T cell acute lymphocytic lymphoma. So it is not leukemia, it is lymphoma because it is present in thymus and it forms cohesive mass in the thymus. And why is it called precursor? Because it is developing from precursor cells, and as it's developing from precursor T cell, and it's developing from precursor cell, and these precursor cells are a bit immature cells, so this tumor also falls in the category of acute precursor T cells neoplasms. Okay, so if a tumor develops from these peripheral cells, either CD8 positive T cell or CD4 positive T cell, so this tumor will be known as peripheral this was all about the classification of leukemias and lymphomas. Thank you.